Welcome to Audio Shelf.
Paper 3 for JAIIB, Legal Aspects of Banking, File Number 4, Unit 47, Unpaid Seller, Clause 500, Rights of an Unpaid Seller. A table has given to explain this. It has been divided into two, rights against the goods and rights against the buyer personally. Rights against the goods further divided into two, where the property in the goods have passed and where the property in the goods have not passed. Where the property in the goods have passed, there are lien, stoppage in transit and resale. In the property in the goods have not passed, withholding delivery and stoppage in transit. Rights against the buyer personally has been divided into suit for price, suit for damages, repudiation of contract, suit for interest. A seller who has accepted negotiable security as an absolute payment is no longer an unpaid seller. An unpaid seller has the following rights. 1. A lien on the goods for the price while he is in possession of them. 2. In case of the insolvency of the buyer. 2. In the case of the insolvency of the buyer, a right of stopping goods in transit after he has parted with the possession of them. 3. A right to resale. 4. A right to withhold delivery of goods. Unit 48. Definition, meaning and nature of partnership. Clause 506. Partnership is the relation between persons who have agreed to share the profits of a lawful business carried on by all or any of them acting for all. There is mutual relation of agency between the partners. Any partner can, by his acts, bind all the partners of the firm. Types of partnership. 1. Partnership at will. 2. Partnership for a fixed period. Partnership agreement for a fixed period. 3. Particular partnership for completing particular job. Unit 50. Relations of partners to third partners. Clause 518. A partner is the agent of the firm for the purpose of the business of the firm. An act done by a partner to carry on the kind of business done by the firm in the usual way binds the firm. This authority of a partner to bind the firm is called his implied authority. The partners in a firm may be mutual agreement amongst themselves, extend or restrict the implied authority of any partner. Every partner is liable jointly with all other partners and also severally for all acts of the firm while he is a partner. Holding out. When a person who is not at all partner in a firm either represents himself or knowingly permit himself to be represented as a partner in a firm, and as a result of this, he induces others to give credits to the firm, he is known as a partner holding out. A transfer by a partner of his interest in the firm does not entitle the person to whom the interest is transferred, transferee, to interfere in the conduct of the business, but entitles the transferee only to receive the share of profits of the transferring partner, and the transferee has to accept the account of profits agreed by the partners. Unit 51. Minor admitted to the benefits of partnership. Clause 526. A person who is the minor cannot be a partner in a firm, but with the consent of all the partners, he may be admitted to the benefits of the partnership. The minor has a right to share the property and profits of the firm as may be agreed upon by all the partners, and the minor can have access to the accounts of the firm. All the partners of the firm are personally liable for all the liabilities of the firm. However, only the minor's share is liable for the acts of the firm, but the minor is not personally liable for the acts of the firm and the liabilities arising therefrom. Legal position after the minor attains majority. At any time within 6 months of his attaining majority, or of his obtaining knowledge that he had been admitted to the benefits of the partnership. Becomes a partner and not become a partner. Becomes a partner. 1. He writes and liabilities as a minor continue up to date on which he becomes a partner, but he also becomes personally liable to the third parties for all acts of the firm done since he was admitted to the benefits of the partnership. Not to become a partner. 1. His rights and liabilities shall continue to be those of a minor up to date on which he given public notice that he does not want to become a partner. Becomes a partner. 2. His share in property and profits of the firm shall be the share to which he was entitled as a minor. Not to become a partner. 2. His share shall not be liable for any acts of the firm done after the date of the notice. Not to become a partner. 3. He shall be entitled to sue the partners for his share of the property and profits. Unit 52. Dissolution of firm. Clause 526. A partnership firm can be dissolved. Dissolution by agreement. A firm can be dissolved with the consent of all the partners. Compulsory dissolution. A firm is dissolved. A. If all the partners are adjudicated insolvent. B. By the happening of any event which makes it unlawful for business itself. Dissolution on the happening of certain contingencies. A firm is dissolved in following circumstances. A. If the partnership is constituted for a fixed term, then by the expiry of that term. B. If the partnership is constituted to carry out one or more adventures or undertaking, then by the completion thereof. C. By the death of the partner. And D. By the adjudication of a partner as an insolvent. To avoid dissolution in these cases, the partners should expressly agree that the firm shall not be dissolved. Dissolution by the court. A. That a partner has become of unsound mind. B. He has become permanently incapable of performing the duties. C. Partners willfully or persistently commits breach of agreements. Liability for acts of partners done after dissolution. Any partner of the firm must give a public notice to the effect that the firm is dissolved. This is because even after dissolution of a firm, the partners continue to be liable to third parties for any act done by any of them until such notice is given. Unit 53, Effect of Registration, Clause 530. A company is compulsorily is required to be registered with the ROC under the Companies Act 1956. However, partnership firm is not required to be registered. A partner of an unregistered firm cannot file a suit against other partners to get his share of profits. An unregistered firm cannot enforce by way of a suit any right arising by a contract against any third party. Unit 54. Definition and Features of the Company. Clause 535. Section 3 of the Companies Act 1956 defines a company as a company formed and registered under this act or an existing company. Distinction between a company and partnership. A table has given there. Company, partnership. Registration, company, compulsory. Partnership, not compulsory. Number of members or partners. Company, private company 2 to 50, public company 7 to unlimited. Partnership, banking business 2 to 10, other business 2 to 20. In number of directors. Company, private company 2, public company 3 to 10. Legal status. Company, separate legal existence. Partnership, does not have a separate legal existence. Ownership of property. Company, by the company itself. Partnership, owned by the partners. Management. Company, by a board of directors elected by shareholders. Partnership, by partners. Perpetual existence. Company, has a perpetual existence. Partnership, does not have a perpetual existence. has a perpetual existence. A contracts, company, a member of the company can contract with the company. Partnership, a partner cannot contract with the partnership firm. Liability, company, except in case of a company with unlimited liability, the liability of the company is unlimited. Partnership, the liability of partners in a partnership is unlimited. Transfer, company, a transferee of shares in a company becomes a member of the company. Partnership, a person can become a partner in a partnership firm with the consent of all the partners. Death, company, death of any or all members does not determine the existence of the company. Partnership, death of a partner dissolves the partnership unless the partnership deed provides otherwise. Agency, company, not the agents. Partnership, each partner of a firm is an agent of the other. Features of the company. A. Registration. A company has to be compulsorily registered under the Companies Act 1956. B. Artificial legal person created by law and can be dissolved by law alone. It is invisible, intangible and exists only in the eyes of law. It enjoys many rights of natural person. C. Independent corporate personality. A partnership has no existence apart from its members. D. Limited liability. E. Perpetual succession. F. Separate property. G. Transfer of shares. H. Common seal. I. Corporate veil is said to be lifted off or pierced when the court ignores the separate entity of the company. Unit 55. Types of companies. Clause 542. Classification of companies on the basis of mode or incorporation. Statutory company created by special act. Registered under the Companies Act 1956. Companies incorporated and registered under the Companies Act. Liability. Company limited by shares. The member is not bound to pay anything more than the fixed amount on the share. Company limited by guarantee. Where the liability of the members of the company is limited by the memorandum of association to such an amount as the members undertake to contribute to the assets of the company in the event of liquidation of the company. Company with unlimited liability, where the liability of the members is unlimited. Public interest. Private company is defined in Section 3 of the Companies Act. 1. Minimum paid up capital rupees 1 lakhs. 2. Only 2 directors and 2 members. 3. Need not obtain certificate of commencement. 4. Only gets certificate of incorporation. 5. A private company need not hold a statutory meeting and submit a statutory report to the ROC. Public company. 1. Minimum paid up capital rupees 5 lakhs. 2. Minimum 7 members and 3 directors. 3. Appointment and remuneration payable to the directors applicable to a public company, not applicable to a private company. Government company. 51% of the paid up share capital by government, central or state. Foreign company. Incorporated outside India but has place of business in India. Holding and subsidiary companies. A company is deemed to be subsidiary of another. 1. Other company controls the majority of composition of board of directors. 2. The other company holds majority of shares. 3. Holding company subsidiary has its own subsidiary. It becomes subsidiary of the first mentioned company. Unit 56. Memorandum of Association and Articles of Association. A table has given here. Memorandum of Association. The first step in the formation of company is the preparation of the Memorandum of Association. It is a document of great significance as it embodies the fundamental rules regarding the constitution and scope of activities of the company. Articles of Association. It consists of a set of rules or regulations and bylaws made by the company for internal management of the company and for carrying out the objects of the company embodied in its MOA. Memorandum of Association. A company is legal person and hence it must have a name to be identified. Name of the state in which the registered office of the company is situated. A company shall, from the date on which commences business or within 30 days after the date of incorporation, whichever is earlier, should have registered office. It should clearly state the objects or nature of the business of the company for which the company is established. Liability clause. If the company is to be incorporated with limited liability, the liability clause must state that the liability of the members shall be limited by the unpaid amount on shares. Capital clause. Amount of share capital which the company will be authorized to raise and the number and the value of shares into which it is divided. Articles of Association. The Companies Act 1956 requires that Articles of Association must be filed together with the MOA by the following kind of the companies. Unlimited company. The AOA must state number of members with which the company is to be registered. Company limited by guarantee. The AOA must state number of members with which the company is to be registered. Private company limited by shares. The AOA must contain the restrictive conditions peculiar to a private company, that is, with respect to prospectus, deposits, number of members, and transfer of shares. Distinction between with MOA and AOA. Memorandum of Association contains fundamental conditions upon which the company is incorporated. Articles of Association, internal regulations of the company. Memorandum of Association, it states purpose of the company and reasons for which company. Articles of Association, subordinate to MOA. Memorandum of Association, clauses in MOA can be altered only by a special resolution passed by the company and with the sanction of Company Law Board. AOA. Any terms of AOA can be altered by a special resolution and no approval from the company law board or any other authority required. MOA. If a company commits an act in contravention of the MOA, example, company having objects only to manufacture biscuits starts activities of bottling milk without proper amendments in object clause, then the acts done and liabilities arising therefrom are not binding on the company and the same cannot be ratified by the company. AOA. If a company does something in contravention of the provisions of the AOA, it is only a procedural irregularity and the same can be ratified by the shareholders at a general meeting and thus rectified. Unit 23. Doctrines of ultra-vires and or construction notice. Doctrine of ultra-vire. Doctrine of constructive notice. Doctrine of indoor management. A table has given here. Ultra-vire. Company cannot carry out the objects which are not stated in MOA. 1. If a company's money has been spent ultra vires in purchasing any property that belongs to that company. 2. If a director of company makes an ultra vires payment, he is personally liable to the company. 3. Director or agents of the company, they must act within limits of the power of the company. Breach of authority. Constructive notice. Every outsider is assumed to have knowledge of MOA and AOA. Indoor management. Outsiders are not required to see the compliance of internal regulations of company. If outsider has actual knowledge of internal regularity of the company, he is not entitled to claim protection of this doctrine. Unit 58. Members. In case of companies having no share capital, there are members but not shareholders. According to the Companies Act 1956, the term member of a company means the subscribers of MOA, every other person who agrees in writing to become a member of a company and whose name is entered in its register of members, every person holding equity share capital of a company and whose name is entered as beneficial owner in the records of the depository shall be deemed to be a member of the concerned company. various modes of becoming a member of a company. 1. By subscribing to MOA. 2. Membership by allotment shares. 3. Transfer of shares. 4. Transmission of shares. 5. Membership by acquisitions. 6. Joint membership. Who can be members of a company? 1. Any person competent to contract. Every person who is competent to contract can become member of a company. 2. Minor and persons of unsound mind cannot be member as they are incompetent to contract. 3. Company as member. As a company is a legal person, it can become a member of another company. 4. Partnership firm. Since a partnership is not a legal person, it cannot buy shares in its own name and thus become member of the company. 5. Registered society. Can hold shares in a company. 6. Non-residents. A NRI cannot become a member without complying with the requirements of the FEMA 1999 and without permission of RBI. 7. Fictitious persons. Any person who makes a fictitious name an application to a company, induces a company to allot or register any transfer of shares to him or any other person in a fictitious name, shall be punishable with imprisonment for a term which may extend to 5 years. Cessation of membership in a company. 1. If a member transfers his shares to another person. 2. If a member shares are forfeited. 3. If the shares are sold pursuant to a decree of court. 4. If the member surrenders his shares. 5. If a member is adjudicated insolvent. 6. On the death of the member. Rights of members. Clause 564. Statutory rights. 1. Priority to have new shares offered in case the company proposes to increase capital. 2. Transfer of shares. 3. To inspect the register of members. 4. Appoint directors and auditors. 5. To convene an extraordinary general meeting of the company. 6. To file petition to the High Court to order winding up the company. Documentary rights, proprietary rights. Unit 59. Prospectus. A public company can raise funds for its business from the public by issuing a document known as prospectus. Private companies cannot issue prospectus to raise funds from the public. It is prohibited under the AOA of the company. It is necessarily the public companies issue the prospectus. Compliance with respect to prospectus. Prospectus. Time of issue. A prospectus can be issued only after the incorporation of the company. Contents. Section 56, read with Schedule 2 of the Companies Act 1956, stipulates the mandatory provisions that are to be stated in the prospectus. Date of publication. Section 55 states that a prospectus must be dated. Signatures. A prospectus must be signed by all directors. Application form. Every application form for shares must be accompanied by a copy of the prospectus. Statements by experts. Expert comments. Registration of the prospects. Registration with ROC is necessary. Misstatements in a prospectus and remedies. A person who has been induced to subscribe for shares or debentures on the faith of the statements in a prospectus which is untrue has twofold remedies. 1. Remedies against the company. The person can rescind the contract, claim damages from the company. 2. Remedies against the promoters and experts. A suit can be filed against the promoters and experts. 3. Criminal liability. Section 56 requires certain matters and reports must be stated in the prospectus. Failure to do so will render the director or any other person responsible for the issue of such prospectus to be punished with fine. Section 63 provides that if prospectus contains an untrue statement, very person who is responsible for the untrue statement in the prospectus shall be punishable with fine or imprisonment or with both. Unit 60. Directors. 1. Every public company or private company having a paid-up paid up share capital of rupees 5 crores must have a managing director. 2. A person cannot act as a director unless within 30 days of his appointment he signs and files with the register his consent to act as a director. 3. At least 2/3 of the total number of directors of a public company are to be persons whose period of office is liable to determination by the retirement by rotation. 4. Additional directors, alternate directors and casual vacancies in the board of directors is filled by the board of directors. Table has given company minimum directors, maximum directors and minimum paid up share capital. 1. Private minimum directors 2. Maximum directors 12. Public minimum directors 3, maximum directors 12 and minimum paid up share capital rupees 5 crores. Vacation of office by directors. The office of a director becomes automatically vacant if 1. He fails to obtain qualification shares. 2. He is found to be unsound mind by the court. 3. He is adjudged an insolvent. 4. He is convicted by court. 5. He fails to pay any call in respect of shares. 6. He is removed by shareholders by passing resolution. A table has given for liquidation and dissolution or winding up the company. Perpetual, forever. Ultra vires, beyond the powers of. Intra vires, within the powers of. Ratification, subsequent approval. Liquidation, acquisitions, dissolution or wind up of the company, agreement. Underwriter, a person agrees with the company that if the public does not subscribe a particular number of shares, then the underwriter would purchase or subscribe to the shares. Underwriting agreement. Agreement entered into between the company and an underwriter. Unit 61. Foreign Exchange Management Act 1999. Clause 582. FERA. FERA. The main objective of the Foreign Exchange Regulation Act 1973, FERA, was to 1. Consolidate and amend the law. 2. Regulate certain payments. 3. Dealing in foreign exchange. 4. The import and export of currency for the conservation of the foreign exchange resources of the country. 4. And finally, the proper utilization of this foreign exchange so as to promote economic development of the company. FEMA, F-E-M-A, the object of enacting Foreign Exchange Management Act 1999, FEMA, is to consolidate and amend the law relating to foreign exchange with the objective of facilitating external trade and payments and for promoting the orderly development and maintenance of foreign exchange market in India. Authorized person, any bank or any person including authorized money changer or dealer authorized under FEMA to deal in foreign exchange or securities. Capital transaction account. A transaction by which there is a change in the assets or liabilities outside India of persons resident in India or assets or liabilities in India of persons or resident outside India. Current account transaction. Any transaction other than capital account transaction. Foreign currency. Any currency other than Indian currency, foreign exchange, amount payable in foreign currency and drafts, traveler checks, LC or bill of exchange drawn in Indian currency but payable in foreign currency. Foreign security, to include shares, stocks, bonds and debentures, government securities, etc. However, it does not include bill of exchange or promissory notes. Person resident in India. Residing in India for more than 182 days in the preceding financial year. Person resident outside India. None. Repatriate to India. Bringing into India foreign exchange and selling it to an authorized person in India in exchange of rupees. Regulation and management of foreign exchange. 1. Deal transfer any foreign exchange or foreign security to any person other than an authorized person. 2. Makes any payment to any person resident outside India. 3.
Receive any payment on behalf of any person resident outside India. 4. Enter into any financial transaction in India in relation to a right to acquire any asset outside India by any person. Powers of RBI with respect to authorized persons. 1. To appoint authorized person deals in foreign exchange. 2. RBI has the power to inspect the authorized persons so appointed to ensure that the said person complies with all the rules and regulations of RBI. Contravention, penalties, adjudication and appeals. Clause 585. An adjudicating authority can inquire contravention under FEMA only if complaint is filed by central government. Adjudicating authority has to endeavor to dispose of the complaints within 1 year from the date of receipt of the complaint. Special Director Appeals, Appellate Tribunal, High Court, Supreme Court. Penalty can be levied up to thrice the sum involved in such contravention where such amount is quantifiable or up to rupees 2 lakh, where the amount is not quantifiable and where such contravention is a continuing one, further penalty of rupees 5000 per day. Unit 62, Transfer of Property Act, 1882, Clause 590. Mortgage is a transfer of an interest in specific immovable property as a security for the repayment of a monetary liability. The transferor is called mortgagor. The transferee is called a mortgagee. Types of mortgage. Simple mortgage. 1. Does not deliver possession of the mortgage property. 2. Mortgagor himself personally to pay the mortgage money. In the event of his failing to pay, the mortgagee shall have right to get the mortgage property sold and recover his dues. Mortgage by conditional sale. The mortgagor apparently sells the mortgage property to the mortgagee with the condition that on default of payment on a certain date, the sale becomes absolute, the sale shall become void, the buyer, mortgagee, shall transfer the property to seller, mortgagor. Usufructuary mortgage. 1. Gives possession. 2. To retain such possession until payment of mortgage money. 3. To receive rents and profits arising from the property. 4. Appropriate the same towards payment of interest of mortgage money or both. English mortgage. The mortgagor binds himself to repay the mortgage money on a certain date and transfer the mortgaged property absolutely to the mortgagee. 2. Subject to the condition that he will retransfer it to the mortgagor upon payment of the mortgage money. 3. The power of sale without intervention of court if money not paid. Mortgage by deposit of title goods. 1. The mortgagor delivers documents of title. 2. With the intent to create a security thereon. 3. The delivery of documents of title is done in a town specified by state government. A mortgage other than a mortgage by deposit title deeds can be effected only in terms of a mortgage deed duly signed by the mortgagor and attested by at least two witnesses. The essentials of valid equitable mortgage is debt, deposit of title deeds and intention as security. Leases of immovable property. A lease is a transfer of a right to enjoy the property for a certain time on in perpetuity, that is forever, in consideration of a price paid or promised to be given periodically to the transferor by the transferee. A lease for agriculture or manufacturing purpose is deemed to be a year-to-year lease. This lease can be terminated by the leaser or lessee by giving 6 months notice to one another. A lease for any other purpose is deemed to be a lessee from month to month. A lease for any other purpose is deemed to be a lease from month to month. It can be terminated by giving 15 days notice to one another. Legal aspects of banking completed.